Okay, today on Alpha Life we'll be making some copper carbonate from sodium carbonate and copper sulfate. So let's get to it. This is quite easy. All you're gonna take a sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate solution and add it to your copper sulfate solution. The way you make a copper sulfate solution, you can modify this if you want to. Any copper sulfate solution will work. The more concentrated, the better. But all you do is take 1.6 grams of copper sulfate and dissolve it in 5 grams of water, or actually 5 milliliters of water, to get a okayly concentrated solution of copper sulfate. This is my good experience. This is what I've been using to make my copper carbonate. And the way I indicate when it's done is just it stops fizzing whenever I add the solution of sodium carbonate. So I'm just gonna add the sodium carbonate. You want to add it slowly. And you can scale up this experiment. You can follow the instructions on how to do this on a larger scale Robert Bruce Thompson's book on home chemistry. It's called Home Chemistry. Home Chemistry Experiments, No Lecture, that's what it's called. I have the book. A lot of the experiments I don't do because I've already done them, but hey, sometimes I do them. It all depends. And you might be thinking, oh my, that's going to be a bad book. No. Most of my followers and subscribers on YouTube, I haven't given you guys my Twitter or anything, but some of my followers on Twitter or the Facebook, which I haven't posted yet, but I'll be posting soon, know that Robert Bruce Thompson's book is good. It's not crap like some books you'll get that won't give you much information on doing it. But, yeah, so I'm almost done dissolving all of my stuff. Oh, don't overflow. Okay. And now I'm just going to keep adding this carbonate solution to it. Okay, so now that you got the carbonate solution done, you can now add this to a filter, which I'm gonna filter it right now. Okay. I'll move that over and just add it to my filter. I'm gonna wash it a couple times. You should wash your test tube out, like I'm doing, if you can see that. I'm not using my tripod today. It's in the fixings. And yes, they do make a modification for a tripod for your iPhone, which I think is really cool. It helps me out a lot whenever I'm using my iPhone as a camera, and not my camera as a camera. Weird, huh? Now I'm just gonna let that filter through, and I'll get back to you whenever. Okay. So I've got it out and out of the filter paper. Okay, so I've got it out of the filter paper. And I'll scrape it out to a jar. And it's right here. This is actually 2 runs of the experiment. And a lot of it's put onto a stuck on filter paper, which I'll get whenever it dries. So that's it. I'll talk to you guys in the next clip on how this is done, like what the process is, the mechanism basically, the reaction, that's the word, the reaction that's going on. So I'll see you guys in the next okay, I'm just gonna run through this really quickly because my camera is running out of memory. Has about a couple minutes of memory left. So what happens is 2 moles of copper sulfate and 2 moles of sodium carbonate or bicarbonate. The H2O comes from water that dissolved in. You get your copper sulfate reacts with the your 2 moles of copper sulfate react with 2 moles of sodium carbonate that they're both dissolved in the water. You get your copper carbonate and your sodium sulfate, and then your byproducts are your sodium sulfate and CO2 that comes off as the gas. So yeah, that's really all it is. We'll be using the copper carbonate in an upcoming video to make copper and other copper compounds like copper chloride and